Hey everyone, welcome back. It's time to put your skills to the test with the latest GoSkills Excel challenge. Joining us today is Microsoft trainer Deborah Ashby. Check out her challenge coming up right now.
Hello everyone, are you ready for another Excel challenge? Here's the scenario. In this challenge, we need to tidy up some data and make sense of this data using a pivot table. And the data that we're going to be using is some data based on coffee sales. Now, I've just imported this data into a spreadsheet, and you can see that this data has numerous different problems. The first problem being that it's all contained within one column, as opposed to being separated neatly into multiple columns. You can also see we have some rows in here, which we don't really need. And we also have a lot of inconsistent spacing, a lot of erroneous spaces in each of these rows. So the first part of this challenge is to tidy up this data so that everything is in nice, neat columns without any spaces or strange characters. And I'd like you to use Power Query to do this. Once you have the data set open in Power Query, I want you to use the tools within the Power Query editor in order to tidy up this data. So think about how we might split this data into separate columns. Think about what character is being used as the delimiter. I'd like you to remove any rows or columns that we don't need. And I'd like you to make sure that all of the data types for each column are set correctly. And what I mean by data types, if you're not familiar, is that when we have text in a column, I want you to make sure the data type is set to text. If we have currency, I want you to make sure the data type is set to currency. And I'd like you to remove or trim any erroneous spaces from all of the columns. And I'd also like you to trim the column headings as well. We basically don't want any weird spaces anywhere. Once you have the data nice and tidy, I'd like you to load it back into Excel as an Excel table. Once you've tidied up the data and loaded it back into Excel as a table, it should look something like this. And then the next step of this challenge is to create a pivot table based off of this data. And this is what I would like your pivot table to look like. So we're summarizing our data by item type, and we're just summing the total. Notice that I've applied a very specific table design, so I'd like you to do that to get it to look the same. I've added a slicer, and I've changed the layout of that slicer so that the coffee sizes are running horizontally as opposed to vertically in that slicer. Also notice that I've turned off the slicer heading to make this look a little bit cleaner. And the final thing that I've done here is I've added a column that shows what the total is when we add on 20% tax. Now the tax data doesn't exist in our original source data. So you need to think about how you're going to do this and how you're going to add this calculated field. I'd also like you to make sure that you have the correct number formatting applied, and I'm using accounting formatting with two decimal places, and I'd like you to sort the items by the total field so that we have the largest at the top. Once you've done all that, we can click around with the slicer to make sure everything is working, and that is the challenge. So quite a few steps there that are really going to help you flex your data analysis muscles. I have my own solution that I happen to like very much. Can you figure out what it is? Download the exercise file and let me know if you have the answer before we release the solution video. And don't forget to hit the subscribe button below to get notified.
Do you have what it takes to complete this challenge? To get started, click the link below to download all the files you need. Let us know how you're doing in the comments section. Or, even better, join the GoSkills Slack channel and chat with other Excel pros about your progress. Link in the description. If you'd like to know the solution to this challenge, hit that subscribe button and get notified when the next video drops with all the step-by-step instructions on how to solve it. Good luck, everybody!